Alright, so we're maxed out on power and contacts, so the next priorities are to build a power grid and a comm center, but for now I'm just opening stuff up. I'm building the Privy Grand as part of the story.
And go colonize one of their planets.
Hey, Commander.
Yes, colonize one of their planets. What could go wrong? Let's see, flashbang disorients enemies within a radius. Could be really handy against stuff like the stunning characters. Mind shield, smoke grenade. Yeah, smoke grenade's really handy for just keeping a specific character healthy. Kinda just wanna start developing some of these. Smoke grenade in particular is something I like. I don't know. We're really low on resources.
I saw Tygen muttering to himself in one of the corridors. I'm not sure he even noticed me.
Rumor from the Resistance airstrip. 6 days to investigate it. Reward is Resistance contacts. Except I can't make any more contacts right now until I do otherwise. A commander, after our recent success, members of the Resistance in East Asia have brought us reports of activity that we may want to investigate. Not right now. It's worth looking into, but for now I can't get any more contacts. So I want to finish making contact with West Asia for the story.
Setting course for Sector 15, West Asia.
And here we go.
Commander, we have a priority message coming through. It looks like an encoded signal from the Resistance. Patching it through to your quarters now.
It would seem your recent activities have gotten Advent's attention. Our unwelcome guests are on the move. Advent has been diverting considerable resources and personnel to covert facilities across the globe. The exact details of these operations are highly classified. However, they do have one thing in common. A single word that appears in all their files. Avatar.
Right, that's just the recap about Avatar Project again. We've covered all this before, I had to rewind time.
It sounds like it'll be the end for all of us.
Oh, interesting. Avatar Project... At the time, I thought that we got the three pieces of Avatar Project listed up because I failed the mission, but it looks like that just kind of happens regardless. Okay. That's just fine. Let's go ahead and continue making contact. They like to interrupt me a lot.
These findings All right. will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander.
Alright, we gained 60 intel. Let's go ahead and choose our next thing. Oh yeah, I haven't read this one yet. The alien data cache appears to be a physical storage device intended for direct interface with the data pads we've seen the Advent forces carrying in the field. Having successfully decrypted the files, including a variety of tactical data and varying intelligence, I have yet to discover what it is about this data in particular that requires the aliens to maintain physical stores of critical information. Considering the sophistication of their technology in general, we would think the inherent security risks involved would be enough to dissuade them. In any case, it can only benefit us to seize these assets whenever possible. Artigan. Whenever they say stuff like that, like, you think they just wouldn't do this? It kind of makes me feel like someone made a bunch of mechanics for game design purposes, and then the writers are just like, huh, look at all these things that don't make sense because they're wanted it for gameplay reasons. Well, Resistance Radio is the next thing to do, more or less. It's also how we proceed to expand our range. There's a few other options, but they would just take a long time. Either Stun Lancer or Resistance Radio is a reasonable thing to go for. Resistance Radio is how we continue moving forward with the world. And we have to do the research first, and then we have to build the actual building. So it makes sense to get that out of the way now.
I've seen members of the crew quietly glancing at the scar on my neck. If I wasn't forced to remove the chip myself, the
Here we go, still making contact.
Objective added.
Alright, the mysterious Advent Black Site must be investigated at by an XCOM strike team, and any relevant artifacts must be recovered for study. Complete the Advent Blackside mission.
Commander, we've established contact with the local resistance and we're ready to move on the alien Blackside on your order. Advent's been keeping this facility a closely guarded secret. We should make sure our troops are ready for a tough fight before we send them out there.
We're ready to move when you are, Commander. I've updated our objectives based on the latest information.
All right, new income, 49 supplies.
New regional contacts located.
And our risk map is expanding. So this is our new objective, right? Operation Frozen Key, Advent Blacksite, 125 supplies. That's the big story mission. Okay. I believe we finally got a sergeant, didn't we? Let's go back to our map. So, do we have a sergeant now? So can I do this finally? Squad size 1, 50 supplies, absolutely. For the love of God, give me another soldier to help cover all the other soldiers from dying. And then for now we can't afford the other things. Lightning Strike, units gain +3 mobility for the first 2 rounds of battle while the squad remains concealed. Also really handy, but I think extra soldier is worth more. Bonus experience, that's nice. An overall faster progression of leveling up. Vulture, enemies drop an additional item, yep. As you'd expect, basically every item here is really handy, but more than anything, I definitely want to just get a fifth soldier out there so they can all cover each other more consistently. And we have more firepower. I finally have access to that. Finally. How are we doing at the armory here? Is that character still disabled? 17 days. Yeah, Hooded Atheist had a bad time. I even tried to heal them up for the specific purpose of avoiding that getting worse, but it didn't necessarily fully fix things. Thankfully, we have several specialists, so it's not the biggest problem. Let's see, which class would I double up on? Well, I only have one Grenadier and I only have one Sharpshooter, so I can't go with either of those, so given the options, I think I would probably double up on Rangers if I could if I was going to bring in my fifth character. Here we go. No, not much reason to recruit new soldiers right now. At this point, do we just press forward with time? I'm wondering if I should be going for that run or not. I might just pass some time collecting some supplies, because a good collection of supplies means that I could... Yeah, grab some more supplies and then we could actually successfully buy another upgrade before we run in. Let's go for the checkpoint.
Avenger plotting new course.
Chat, I don't know how long I'll stream. I generally stream for however long until I get too tired or something. Later tonight, Wanderbot's supposed to be playing either Divinity or Arslan with me, so I'll probably be streaming until we do that, which will also be streamed.
Proving grounds are ready, Commander. We can build the Skulljack whenever you give the word.
The Skulljack. That's terrifying.
Welcome to the Proving Grounds, Commander. It seemed like a good idea to isolate some of our more experimental concepts, especially when it comes to weapons development.
So what can you do here? So, Skulljack. Before we even had time for field trials, the troops had already taken to calling it the Skulljack. In the simplest terms, it's a physical interface designed to access the chip implanted the Advent Force's skulls, applied using direct blunt force. What does it do, though? Does it just execute them? Or does it actually take intelligence from them? They kind of skipped on saying that, didn't they? About what it does. Experimental ammo. Let's see, 50 supplies. Ilarium core, and... Yeah, Ilarium cores in both cases. Experimental ammo. We've seen aliens using a variety of exotic ammunition in their weapons. Using Ilarium cores we've recovered from the battlefield, we could develop new ammo types of our own that will likely be more potent than any of our current munitions. Higher damage is also encouraging. Experimental grenade. Ilarium cores can be highly unstable given the right circumstances, assuming we don't push it too far. We could fabricate new types of grenades that could easily surpass the effectiveness of what we've got now. Let's see. Can I read about the current objective? Find out why I want the Skulljack. Complete the Skulljack project in the Proving Ground. It's part of accessing the alien network, so it does get information from their brain. Okay, may as well move forward with that, although the ammo is really tempting. I might prioritize the ammo. Just because making my characters do more damage would be a lifesaver for keeping them alive. Also, this would use all of my remaining supplies, which is a bit of a bummer at this point. Yep, I think I'm gonna ignore my current objective and move on without it.
Immediately, Commander. I'll let you know as soon as we've made progress.
There we go. Increases project speed. It's currently an unstaffed engineer. Yes. Absolutely. Project speed plus 50%. Experimental ammo. It still says 10 days, as if... Oh, nope, 5 days. There we go. So it'll be done soon anyway. It will be done soon. Let's go ahead and press forward on time. And you know what? Since that mission was successful... Oh, you have to come all the way back out here to do this? I was just trying to open this. Let's make a new save. 2/18/2016. There we go. Just because I had that successful mission, let's try to save that. That is not the date, it's the 12th. I'm an idiot. Wow. I misread the clock in the darkness. Good job. Moving too fast. Let's go with the supplies.
The outcome of this research can only further our advances, Commander.
There we go. I can just fix the save name later anyway. See, I think we already read this one. Yeah. I think I already started building it before. Faceless autopsy would be quick. Stun Lancer. Let's do Stun Lancer.
The Advent Stun Lancer was apparently outfitted with the intention of serving as a civilian peacekeeping unit within the city centers. Although they are equipped with weapons capable of administering non-lethal blows, recent reports indicate an increasingly aggressive stance taken by these units.
Alright, 3 days till we're done with that. Progress forward.
Commander, based on my research in collaboration with Shen, I believe we can reduce the intel costs of contacting additional regions by building radio relay towers along our network. The further a region is from a relay, the more it will cost us in intel. So I would suggest building relays along the remote edges of our existing network. I believe the Resistance will be grateful for the construction of these relays. They may reward us in kind.
It'll be a good idea, but I can't... I probably can't afford them right now, right? Yeah. I think they generally costed most of their current money. Let's just finish this. I could use this money.
That the Resistance hit an Advent supply line. We have an opportunity to salvage some high-value materials, assuming we can clear out the alien forces guarding the site first.
Well, it's a good thing I just made that new save, just in case. Commander, the Resistance has relayed information concerning an Advent supply line. We should disrupt their transports, alright? Operation Storm Mother! Raid the Advent convoy. Give it a shot.
Setting course for East Asia.
Look at that bigger squad. We're already more equipped than we were before. And Wanderbot's here with his dumb mask and his orange crotch. Alright. That's basically the exact squad I was gonna give us. Let's give you a med kit. Can I not do that? Oh, right. I have to unequip it over here first. Grenade. Med kit. There we go. So our closest range characters have some bonus armor. A couple people have grenades. This should more or less work out. Let's give this a shot.
Sky Ranger deployed.
Menace, ready to deploy.
All right, let's see if we can do two consecutive missions that go well.
Resistance operatives disabled an Advent convoy in this region, and they sent word for us to come in and seize whatever we can. This is the perfect opportunity for us to recover some of their gear. We'll need to secure the AO and neutralize any hostiles still in the area if we're going to get anything of use out of there.
We'll just have to try not to get any more gravely wounded atheists this time around. Supply line raid, Evan Colonoy. Convoy. Neutralize all enemy targets and secure the supplies. So basically just neutralize all enemy targets unless it's a timed explosion again. I like the variety of appearances my characters get just from going from the random generator.
Menace 1-5, the disabled advent convoy is just ahead. Engage and eliminate all hostile forces.
I guess I should take that back. I just realized that I customized almost everyone in this party, didn't I? I gave her the hat and the ponytail, I think. I gave Wander the helmet. I gave him the eraser top to honor the silly hair that was replaced on accident. And I gave him the beanie based on the person that got the name's request. So I guess the only non-customized person is Darren. But they're mostly the way they started out. Avoid destroying critical okay, we're doing one of these again. So we have no time limit. This is our time to be cautious and careful and not get everyone murdered, presumably. Do we have an idea of the boundary of the map? This is the right boundary of the map. Is there a bottom boundary? It's all the way down here. Okay. See if I can get an idea of how far this one goes. Oh! That's the boundary of the map right here, too. So we're actually dead center of the map as far as this wall goes, but there's a big cliff over here that makes it hard to explore that direction, and who knows if there's even more enemies over there or not. But I could go over by this building for some cover on my way in. Does it go on for a while in the other directions? Yeah, it looks like it does. You can't really get a sense for how far it is because it's all gray screen anyway, but it's far, apparently. So with what we got, let's see, we'll start with our ranged characters. I mean, our shotgun characters as we approach this area to see what's over here. It's right next to the starting point, so I should definitely get an idea of what's there. You can similarly take cover right over here.
Confirmed.
No bad guys yet, and the wall's right over here, so there can't be that much more. This is all an in route. There is a rather important looking barrier over here. Let's see, this will be probably a long mission because I'm going to be really cautious, most likely.
Okay.
Just make our time around. Let's see, get everyone behind cover, first of all. Just so we're not standing in the open in case someone surprises us a little early. Do we get him? Yeah. The tough thing is before you see enemies, you don't know what direction to take cover from yet.
Heading out.
I could always just hop into, do I push forward with you? Let's push forward the most with you. And see if that gives us line of sight on someone. Nothing yet.
Overwatch.
I'm gonna go ahead and just pop people into Overwatch.
Got it covered.
Since we're raiding people, they're not... I might as well just wait to see if anyone approaches me between turns. There's no time limit, so we don't have to be too aggressive. And going too fast is how we've lost people in the past.
Moving to designated coordinates.
A little more. Still no line of sight, huh? Here, what if I press up to this tree?
That's affirmative.
Just the ever slight bit of spread. Burning car. Can I see behind this facility now? More or less, there's a tiny spot that's a blind spot right now, but it's most likely that there's no one in that direction. Let's just inch forward using trees for cover. Trees and their nice 100% defense bonus. Always happy to see that. Ooh, that's a bi-directional piece of cover. That's nice. Let's get Kraus forward. He's got a nice place to camp out for a bit. And Zulu cannot get proper cover from here. We'll press forward a little bit.
Closing on target position now.
Taking it slow. I'll let two characters sprint per turn at maximum, I think.
Affirmative.
Oh!
The introduction of human DNA.
Snakes!
These creatures, once operating under the guise of thin men, now show their true form.
Alright, I'd very much like to kill that guy before he gets a turn, because fuck snakes.
The aliens don't need an infiltration unit anymore. Eyes on the prize.
Just in case I get spotted by anyone wandering this way. But yeah, I'll keep leapfrogging forward. Fucking snakes, man. That was the most metal death ever, right? What happened last time? There was a burning car, and a snake grabbed one of my characters like a goddamn, smoker? I think they're called from Left 4 Dead? I've played the game so long ago now that I actually am forgetting the names of iconic monsters.
Okay.
He pulled him in like a smoker, and then the car, it coiled around him in snake mode, and then the car exploded on him, and it's like, that's how a squad member died. That was insane. It's actually... Let's see here. I just want to see how many people can see that. Ooh, 90% chance is promising. It's certainly somewhat tempting to go after this guy. Especially if I get a few characters a little closer. That's only 50% cover? Interesting. These are all shitty cover. Albeit closer.
I'm on the move.
Take a look at Darren. Yeah, Darren can't make it to very much cover either. This strategy does limit you somewhat, and the people in this party that can make the shot from here is somewhat limited. Statistically, I'm most likely to kill the snake in advance, but I do feel like my chances are somewhat iffy. That said, if I can bring them to me, that's not a terrible idea. Let's review that chance really quick on the snake. It is not the best. Now, you're the only person besides the sniper that can take the shot, because I'd rather have more shots than that taken. You can take the shot. 69%, okay. That's not unreasonable. Let's prepare an ambush. We have relatively high cover, to the point where I can see them coming my way. I think I'm relatively happy with this spot, as opposed to other options. If I press forward, I might be able to actually contribute here, too. Yeah, these are weirdly accurate shotguns, aren't they?
Affirmative, covering now.
Is that everybody? Everyone except for that guy? I'll let him go into Overwatch in case someone approaches us, but he won't be able to help with this part. Hey, snakey, 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 snakey. Please stop breathing forever. Critical shot. Flawless victory.
Hostile neutralized.
Because fuck snakes. Seriously. Kill, 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 kill. Yeah. Sweet. That was a lot of... That was a weird sound. It was like something was falling downstairs. I'm sure it's just another glitch in this game. It seemed... The quality of the game... There's fidelity issues for sure. Where a few things are certainly iffy. Alright, that's two guys down. I'm just happy to see Snake gone. Hopefully that'll be the only... No, last time there was two snakes in this mission, so it's probably going to be another one. I wonder if they're going to come my way or not, or if they're just going to keep camping out somewhere. There's supplies I'm supposed to not blow up. Let's see. Just pick an assault character, I guess, and leapfrog forward. Like Darren.
Affirmative, moving out.
Any new people? I'm gonna definitely moving our sniper last in case they get the opportunity to go after somebody. That might be that's a little far forward, isn't it? It's just such a nice hiding spot. But yeah, now that we're out of concealed mode, if I see them, they see me. So I don't want to go behind. I don't want to waste my entire turn. I want to take cover here first. In fact, from there I could probably run in there if I wanted to. Yes, I could. But it gives me an opportunity to stop first. in case that's a good idea. Yeah. Have you pressed forward into there? Not the craziest concept.
Double time.
Let's press forward with the specialist now. A few people going into Overwatch will help out. Alright. So the sniper hit somebody all the way out there, so he has pretty good range. So if I Overwatch from here, we can probably still help out. So it's not invalid.
Affirmative. Moving out.
But there's enough people covering right now. Yeah. I may want to press forward still. Especially this nice two-directional cover spot.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Alright.
I'm on it.
Let's keep a healthy amount of cover going on in case they wander over here. I don't know for sure if they do. It might be that if you haven't spotted them yet, they just don't exist by the game's logic. It's a nice cover spot. Let's see. Here we're hitting a gap in the tree line. Let's make our way over here a little bit.
Roger that.
Oh, that's a bad sound. Yep, there's a snake. Oh, he seems friendly. Oh yeah, they're not happy to see us at all. Alright, well, sniper, please tell me you can see snake. Cause I'd like to have him gone real soon here. But that was the snake, wasn't it? Oh, a stun lancer, that's not good either. 67% chance to hit, I'm gonna take it. Come on. Come on. There we go. Not letting me down. Except for the part where it's breathing still. But we can work on that. You know, workshop this idea. Down to 3 hit points. My screen is now fire. They're on low on hit points, so I assume that's the snake. 66. 52. Oh, that's 2 stun lancers. There's a decent chance that this character is going to be ambushed and taken down. Let's take a quick look at our grenadier. Oh, he's really far away. So we probably can't reach them from here, because... Man, those two... Oh, wait, no, they're not. They're probably not in grenade range anyway, huh? It's a 3... How big is the explosion? Actually pretty big. It's a 5-tile across explosion. But possibly too big. Oh, yeah. That's the supplies we're trying not to blow up, so we don't want to fire explosions into it exactly. Oops. Went a little too far back. Press forward and see who we can target from back here. 51%? 50%. Why must you disappoint me? Decent chance of killing if I do hit him, though. Not exactly, actually. It's like a 1 in 3 chance of killing after a 1 in 5 chance. A 1 in 2 chance of hitting. So it could be better. Let's get our specialist into position. Who can you target from here? 49? Alright, it's a decent number of people that can at least take the shot. I could also take the aid protocol to help out. You know what? The most likely person to be targeted by Stun Lancer is our... It's our character up here. If we can avoid taking the hit, I'm gonna try to. There we go. That'll keep you healthy. I can still take a shot, at the very least. That's the only person you can target, so let's go for it. There we go. It's a low hit chance, but between 5 characters, a bunch of low hit chances could potentially take out the entire opposing force. 36. Alright, you haven't moved yet, though, have you? No, you haven't. That's shitty cover. You know what? Someone's gonna try to charge this guy, so I might want to put you in Overwatch. I'll save that for last. Just that decision in general. He's low enough on health, I could just grenade him right now and guarantee the kill. So I think I will.
Catch.
Bye! I like boom. There we go. One bastard down. One stun lancer left to go. I'll probably have Darren overwatch so that he can cover Rose? Yeah, Rose Horowitz. So we'll try to finish the Viper off right now. Nope, that's a miss. I know you can barely see, but that was a miss.
Missed the target.
Unfortunate camera angle. Alright, they're gonna be targeting me now. So let's go into Overwatch. Because I think the Stun Lancer is going to charge us. And he'll probably run into my shotgun range right then. While outside of cover. Hello! Well, that was a miss. But an interesting alternative.
Yeah, I didn't get it.
Okay, I don't like this. This is not what I wanted to have happen today. Holy crap. Dude has war- He actually has more range than I thought he did. I did not think you could make it all the way there. Alright, so my defense bonus amounted to kind of nothing. Okay, given our options, can I melee him off? Is that an option? Where's the waypoint? Where's the... Wait, we have to run all the way around? I can't melee him from over here? So can I do it? Come on. That should be the reasonable response, right? I'm not gonna kill my teammate. Wait, what the fuck? I thought I was gonna melee him. What did I just do? Oh, I just moved him? Oh, son of a bitch. He's just standing inside of him now. That looks reasonable. I thought I was gonna melee him. How do I deal with snakes then? Shit. I've never dealt with a snake before. I don't know what happens. Do I shoot him? Is that gonna kill my teammate? I guess I'll find out. Experimentation time! He dodged the attack. And now he's off. Do I have control with someone over here? Oh, Zulu has control. Alright, melee this fucker. Right now. End him. There we go. Well, at least that's over with. That could have gone so much worse. Rose taking 2 points of damage is about the best case scenario here, so I'll accept that.
Object secure.
Alright, you're like this guy's neighbor right now, so surely you can just shoot him in the face. Yes, you can. But he's hanging in there. Alright, who's left? Just Carl? Carl! That's shit. Alright. That is a shit hit chance, but I could flank him.
Affirmative. Moving out.
And that'll let me take him out. Hello, friend. I like how they start out aiming in the complete wrong direction. Last enemy down until we find more. Are you getting killed by the fire? Is that a thing you do? Does the fire cause you problems? I actually don't know if the fire is bad for you or not in this game. But the good news is everyone we've met so far is dead, which is, would be tragic in any other context. Let's go ahead and, this should be solid forms of cover, yeah. Let's press forward a bit.
Moving to designated coordinates.
Let's check the party for anyone that really needs to reload. You need to reload very badly. Should also probably press forward a little bit while we're doing that.
On the move.
Let's get over here to this rock. Then reload your tragically empty weapon. There
it's
we go. Chat, this episode new timeline this new timeline branches off before Murphy's Law Part 1 or any of the Murphy's Law episodes aired. This is right before any of those episodes where everyone died. Because, that was rather unsalvageable of a loss to have at the very, very, very beginning of the game. Dare I press forward? Let's see. Let's get everyone behind cover real quick.
Moving on target location.
You know what?
That's the equipment we're after. We'll have to do our best to avoid destroying the gear while we secure the area.
Everyone's going to die. I mean, everyone's... No one's about to attack us. It's unlikely someone's gonna charge at us right now, so I think I'm just gonna reload everyone's guns. Now that we're... Just get behind cover and reload. Speaking of getting behind cover.
Moving to designated
there
position.
We go. Yes, Shedai reloaded a save, because the playthrough was dead. I had no soldiers left. And the game was all like, go do this tough mission now. I'm like, yeah, with my zero people, I got this. So I went ahead and reloaded a save from before the session where the three episodes of Murphy's Law were recorded. Because that trilogy of episodes will live on in infamy.
Come get some. Fire's getting worse here.
It's really freaking about the fire thing. Does the fire do anything bad to you, or is he just panicking? Maybe he's freaking out about the fire because in many cases a fire could set off a series of explosions, but that fire is part of the environment design of this level and it's just been sitting here the whole time. This car is just designed for cover. It's probably been used for cover previously, is probably the story for why it looks like that. So you don't want to you don't really want to take cover around this train because that incentivizes enemies to accidentally shoot the things you're trying to salvage in the first place. Let's press forward a little bit. I'm trying to spot our next enemies. Wow, our health points are rapidly increasing for some of these characters. It really does make a difference to level them up a few times. Probably don't want the specialist to run forward too far.
Position confirmed.
All right, Grenadier. I haven't spotted the next guys yet. It's probably safe to move the sniper forward at this point. They're not going to do much from back there.
Position confirmed.
This is going to be a bunny hop. A bunny hop turn. Over here. Why are you ignoring me, game? I'm right clicking. There we go. No one yet. Alright. There's decent cover over here.
Confirmed.
Just gonna keep pressing forward till we see the next bad guys. I think this game might use the same logic as the previous one where the enemies kinda will just hang out until you find them.
Moving on target location.
Alright. Sniper. Not really a place to move forward to yet. Kraus might be able to give you that opportunity. There we go.
Confirmed. Okay.
Being methodical, because when I'm not methodical, we'll die.
On Overwatch.
This is a very large level. Ah, they could be over here somewhere. So where's the end of the level? Is it over here? I can't tell where the end of the level is, it's too gray for me to tell how far the screen's scrolling. Alright. Who's the furthest forward? Darren? Oh, Darren can't reach the next tree without sprinting. How about Kraus? Can you reach this piece of cover? It's not a great cover, but it's something.
On my way.
Any bad guys yet? Really? This is not really progressing much. Dare I sprint? Alright, just one, right? Just one. We're all reloaded. How bad could it get? Oh, there they are. Oh, look, stun lancers. Our favorite. Are they gonna react? There it is. This game reminds me of playing on a, like a Windows 95 computer, where sometimes you'll be playing like a chess game and the game will take a weirdly long time to make its move. That seems to happen regularly on this, which is surprising for this game. Alright, so he could be a target. Not a ton of cover opportunities to get closer. I can kind of get behind this tree a little bit. That may be the move to make. Because right now I'm just too far back. But I'd rather get better cover too. 22%! That is garbage! Alright. Gonna go into Overwatch mode. Because I think the Stun Lancer is going to charge Darren. So the goal is to get the opportunity to stop that. Advent Trooper, 55%. 47% Stun Lancer. 30, yeah, it's garbage. Oh, what the hell? Oh, that's the train, isn't it? That's not even an enemy. Let's see if I can get lucky on the Trooper. No. Nope. Not this time.
Shot wide.
Is it someone's turn right now? There we go. There's a odd camera angle to get stuck on for a moment. So they're in that direction, so cover that faces this direction is actually valid right now. I could take cover here just fine. So I will.
Order's confirmed. On the move.
See if it gives me a decent hit chance. It is not... No line of sight. I still expect that stun lancer to head this way, though, so let's go ahead and just overwatch from here. Oh, I could do aid protocol, actually, to increase the defense of Darren here, who's out front. Avoid him getting clobbered by everything. There we go. I'm just thinking about how a few people are going to be really psyched to be back to being alive right now, because they watched their character die already. Yeah, that thing's covered in supplies, so if I shoot it and blow up that tank, then we're losing our objective. Which would be bad. That guy's very not durable, though, so if I could reach him with a grenade, it's a guaranteed kill. Which I can. So I think I will.
Throw a grenade!
It's one of my favorite things to do with a grenade, is just be like, nope, there's no dice roll here, I can kill this fucker. Chat, I actually read all the time. It's just I'm recording YouTube videos and responding to everyone saying hi over and over again is just not good commentary.
I don't feel so good.
Alright. Well, they were able to reach him just fine. Or reach her. That's not good. Oh, at least we missed. Alright, we were able to avoid the shot. Ooh! Oh, they give me such false... They give me such false hope when they give me that big flashing screen. Because it's like actually 4-6 damage, but they flash the 6. So it's like, oh my god, I'll totally kill him! 67% chance, I'll take that! And then you read the actual number and realize, oh yeah, they're most likely going to be alive. The number's way more important than everything else, but still, I should still shoot this guy. Can I melee him while behind cover is the question, because that has a chance of killing him right here. Yeah, I'd be behind cover from the other guy's perspective. That seems like the thing to do. Fuck you! Oh, one hit point. You just had to, huh? Alright, sniper, who do you have access to? I'd love it if you could take out the guy in the back. Not a great chance, honestly. But you can do lightning hands, which costs no AP. 58% chance. Not this time.
Not good.
Not this time. Let's see, do you have a better shot on the guy in the back? I'm trying to plan whether or not who's gonna go after that guy. No one has a good chance on him, huh? Well, this guy might be able to run to him. That's not bad. That may be the better option right now. Let's go for that. Hey, fucker! Damn it. Really wish he was not alive. Alright, that could have gone better. Alright, whoever has the highest chance of hitting that guy is going to take the shot. 37%. In fact, I was going to say everyone might, but no, someone has to also take out the local guy. You can't even target anyone else, so let's have you take out the Stun Lancer. Please? Good, got him. Stun Lancer down.
Enemy destroyed.
Not a great hit chance. We're going to go for it. It's either that or try to run forward with the pistol, and I don't think the pistol will have better range, better accuracy, will it? Clutch dice roll there. Got him. Did we win?
No longer a threat!
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
There we go. Fantastic. Only one soldier wounded. This is so much better than last time. Whew. 80% successful shot percentage. That's actually a shockingly high number for this game. There we go. Hey, everyone got their own slot on the screen. All four characters. Well, 4 out of 5 characters. No repeats, anyway. Most damage came from the sniper, like you'd expect. Ed top-notch balls. Anyone getting a promotion? If we get a captain, I can get a 6th character in, and then we're a lot better off.
Excellent work, Commander. Your efforts in the field have certainly encouraged the crew.
And the hot pants live on.
That's actually not what hot pants are, huh? Hot pants are like tight shorts or something. I keep commenting on the pink. Alright, so Zulu is gravely wounded, but otherwise good to go. And she continues to be 1 kill ahead of Balls, but Balls is gonna catch up pretty soon because he's not out of commission. Damn, that's a lot of loot. 64 alloy, 131 supplies, a lot of other nonsense and corpses, 3 Illyrium cores, and an alien data cache for more intel. We have to process it all, of course. Let's see. Viper autopsy available. So no one got a promotion, right? So we don't have a captain. Yep, just 2 sergeants. Got 2 of them now, though. That's something. Did I miss my opportunity to upgrade you? Now you have Shadow Step, huh? Does not over... Yeah, I remember buying that a long time ago. Right, okay. Wow, so I actually missed my opportunity to get the 5-unit upgrade in my last playthrough before things went wrong. Because she had already become a sergeant, but then she got kidnapped, so it didn't count as me having a sergeant anymore, so I couldn't buy that upgrade. We have 1 specialist and 1 ranger down. Thankfully, those are both the classes I have duplicates of, at least. I should start training a secondary sharpshooter and grenadier, I'm sure. Probably grenadier first, because the grenadier is the most likely to be injured because of the close range thing. So let's go to... Oh, yeah. So we could get an extra... Drop an extra item, plus 3 mobility, and 25% experience gain. Let's do the soldier thing real quick. Hey, Yusef. Let's go ahead and make you a grenadier. Because no one else is currently training for that. Let's see. So we're currently building... What are we building right now? We're not building anything, are we? Oh right, my only engineer is helping with research, so no one's currently digging out slots. I need to get myself another engineer. But also more money to compensate for things. Let's take a look at our objectives really quick. The black market. So we're getting access to this again. But I was previously doing... Oh yeah, I was trying to do the overgrown checkpoint 3 more days. Could go ahead and press forward with that a little bit. Let's see, what time of the month is it? Do we have a new supply drop to go after soon? Oh, the black market's up there now. They moved it. It was down here before. The airstrip wasn't here last time, though, so some things have changed regardless. I don't know when the next mission's gonna be, so I should probably grab one of those upgrades. Experience would be nice, among other things. You guys having fun there? Who are those 3 characters? Don't think I recognize those characters. Eh, they all look a little the same. Alright, so... That's a lot of supplies. Bonus experience would be nice. Bonus mobility at the beginning would be nice. Enemies drop an additional item with every looted drop. I think I'm gonna go for bonus mobility. Because that would help us save... Yeah, I'm gonna go for that. That would help us save a lot of time. I don't want to completely destroy my supplies, but that would help us save time during those early turns at making more forward progress, which would mean that we're less pressed for time during the last few turns when you know, because all these objectives are so time-oriented lately. Available 8, wounded 2, and unavailable 1. How does a soldier become unavailable? Oh, they're in training. I'm an idiot. All right, valid. Let's go ahead and finish that checkpoint for supplies.
Avenger plotting new course.
Here we go. Now there's a UFO hunting the Avenger. If they keep imprisoning and torturing people, eventually someone's gonna talk.
Commander, remote reconnaissance indicates the aliens have a UFO hunting for our position. We need to be careful about where we pick our flight paths.
Okay. Can't tell which way he's gonna go. He just kinda wanders around. Alright. 63 additional supplies. Now we're up to 151. It's all good news. Let's go ahead and make a new save. After that success we had. And where's the last manual save with the wrong name? Just go ahead and delete that. Bye. We're not going to use you anyway. Right. 2/12/2016. That's the correct date. So do I blow more money on the experience bonus or hold on it? Somewhat torn. Because I should be clearing out more space. Let's finish the experimental ammo and I'll start digging out another space and we'll start working on getting more power and then the comms depot to be able to expand the network more. So for now, let's just keep doing this. We already grabbed it. Yeah, we don't need more contacts. Black market, I'm probably not going to be using right now. It might be valid to go after the next major mission. Or I could just build another tower while we wait. See, plus 74. That one already has a tower. 116. This one would actually be worth more if I built the tower, so let's go over here. 50 supplies, 2 to 4 days, and it would increase my income from that location by about 40. It's a bit of a loss at the beginning, but it'll be worth more in the ultimate. And proving ground projects cost 50% less if we install radios everywhere. It's a bit of an expensive thing to do. I think I'm gonna go for it though.
Setting course for Sector 14, East Asia.
Please stay away, UFO.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Got our stun lancer down.
Although Advent clearly intended for these units to be their means of dealing with any unruly civilians within the city centers, it seems they have come to rely on more brutal means of pacification in the time since.
I don't think I read this one yet. For the Stun Lancer, on both the physical and genetic level, the Advent Stun Lancers are nearly identical to the troopers our forces regularly see in combat. However, a minor yet crucial adjustment to the muscle fiber density of the Lancer improves both agility and overall survivability. Equipped with non-lethal weapons capable of easily disabling human targets, these Lancers were first deployed during the earliest days following Advent's establishment of the city centers, when civil unrest was a more common problem than outright resistance. In studying their usage and deployment, this raised an interesting question. If Lancers were among the first Advent forces deployed, and their survivability is somewhat higher than that of the standard trooper, did the aliens consciously reduce the trooper's strength based on their assignment of human combat readiness? This would imply a system of rapid genetic modification beyond what I had previously imagined the aliens were capable of. It would also demonstrate a degree of genetic frugality that I would have previously assumed was irrelevant to the aliens, based on the variety of unusual experiments they've conducted. Artigan. Now we can start building the Arc Blade. With pure kinetic energy no longer sufficient in the field, the Arc Blade may prove necessary. It boosts the standard sword's combat effectiveness with an addition of an electric field capable of stunning enemies that are not killed outright. Sounds really handy to me. Alright, new soldier. I mean, new topic, we can go for psionics. 5 Valerium crystals, I've got enough for it now. Magnetic weapons is 11 days. Ooh, plated armor. Our understanding of Advent armor is far enough along to allow the fabrication of our own design, mirroring their plated structure. The initial prototypes may be aesthetically rough, but functionally they'll be both light and strong. I do like the idea of getting better armor, because dear lord, the casualties I have seen. 12 days is a little rough, but I would like people to die less. That'd be nice. I think I'm gonna jump on it.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
Okie dokie.
I was not going to admit it to Shen. But there is one thing I miss more than my lab equipment. Those damn juicy Advent burgers. I don't know where they get the meat. And frankly, I do not want to know.
Hello, Commander.
I want a better sword, but that is all of my money. A little rough to make that jump right now, I think. Definitely need more income in general, don't I? God damn. That's why I'm building towers and stuff, though, so I can get more money every turn.
Technology still embedded throughout the ship. Most of the primary systems are now operating on...
Let's finish that radio relay and hopefully not get attacked along the way. Proving ground experimental ammo complete, venom rounds. The tips of these rounds contain microcapsules of fast-acting toxin, effective on organic aliens and humans alike, poisoning the target on impact and dealing bonus damage. One venom round has been added to the inventory. One venom rounds. What? Okay. I assume that means that anyone in the party could be specifically equipped with venom rounds then.
Welcome to the fight.
Signal's coming through clear.
New income, 115 supplies. So we're at 115 plus 165, so overall we have a 279 bonus. Oh, and now we have our Grenadier. Here we go. Yusef the Squatty. Go ahead and customize this guy. So, he is a... Let's go ahead and review. Yeah, making those characters red. Because he's a Grenadier. There's our bright red. We'll go ahead and give you a muted color. Goes well with the hood. Your Spider-Man pattern, apparently. Alright. Looking at the characters we have on our list right now. This one should probably be... Let's go ahead with Jiro. Or Hero. There we go. One more character off the list. We'll slowly make our way through some of those people. There's a lot of them. So welcome to the squad. I should probably pick who to specialize in next. Because now we probably need another sniper. Just to try to even out our squad so that if people do go down, we have the proper people to replace them. Train this rookie, Penny, in sharpshooter. There we go. Have fun. Oh, I do recognize that character. So I guess they are members of my squad being randomized in. I think it's just standardizing them all into one uniform, so I recognize some of them less because I'm used to seeing them in helmets and stuff like that. But a few of them are definitely randoms. Or, rookies we haven't used at all yet. Is the bar also populated by people I know?
Our fallen soldiers, Commander.
It's not much, but it gives our people a chance to pay their respects.
Don't necessarily recognize those people. Who have we lost so far? So Daniel McSween's is continuing as our one named character after an audience member who is permanently dead. Chad is making the point that apparently that upgrade to the shock weapons will actually work for absolutely everybody. Which does make it more tempting. But it's rough that it's all my money. Although when I start emptying out the next area, that'll also give me more money. And soon we'll probably be getting more supplies in general. I think I'm gonna go for it. And I'll be very disappointed if they were not correct. Because a few people have said things that were just wrong immediately, so we'll see how it goes. But if it applies to every single trooper, that'd be very handy. I don't know if I want to get the black market yet, but I don't know what else I would do at this point. We could work on our intel, but our intel's actually pretty okay. Could build more radio towers, but we don't have the money. Is it time to just go for the next mission and pray?